Hi, this is A Minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to talk about why you need to talk about your app and not think that you're annoying people by doing it. Okay, so something really strange happened last week. I was talking to two separate clients on Monday and then again on Friday, and they both said the same thing to me. They didn't know each other, but they both said the same thing. The first one I was talking to her, and I said, we really need to get these app downloads up. You need to get up. You need to start pushing it and marketing it more. And she said, I suppose I need to be more annoying in my marketing efforts. Right, that's what she said. And then, and then later on in the week, somebody completely different said, I suppose I need to be more annoying with people and get them to download my app. Right, and then it rankled me the first time, and it really bothered me the second time, because you know, marketing your app is not being annoying. This is something where I think like salespeople and marketing people, they have a lot more over us mere mortals sometimes, because they're used to going out and talking about things. As I've said time and time again, if there's one thing you know that I want you to get from these videos, is that making the app is the easy part of all of this. Getting people to download it, getting them to notice it is the hardest part, right? The app market is so difficult. I mean, I see this all the time. I see this with developers who are, maybe working like I was working in a bank, and then decided to do their own app, and they're very super confident with the code. They spend far too long working on it, making it perfect, and they release it, and then they're a deer in the headlights because nobody's finding it, nobody's downloading it, because they haven't thought about that process, right? If there's one thing in right now at the end of 2015, when you release an app on the app market, it's like opening a shop on the far side of town, that on a road that nobody ever drives down, and you need to start talking about it. You need to start telling people about it. Hopefully you'll get to the point where people will start, spreading the word for you, and word of mouth will pick up. But until that happens, it's kind of down to you. And there's nothing annoying about that. I mean, of course it's going to be annoying if I go to like a bus stop or something. I mean, this is just, I would never do this. I would never go up to a complete stranger or even my friends and say, hey, you should download EarSpy, cause it's, completely unannounced. However, if somebody's on Twitter and they say, I want to learn Mandarin, then, that's my cue to say, hey, I have a few apps that might be able to help. And if you have a game that's specifically towards a niche like that, like language learners, then you could, respond to that kind of stuff. Or even if it's something that's similar to another game, say you release something that's like, I always use the example of Flappy Birds, but let's say you do a Flappy Birds clone and somebody tweets that, hey, I really like Flappy Birds, then maybe, at that point you could just interject yourself and say, you might also like my app. So it's really difficult working, if you think that you're annoying people, then you're never going to approach them and you're never going to talk to them. The nice thing about social media is that you don't actually have to physically approach anybody. I mean, there's people out there right now talking about what they want or the kind of stuff they want to see. And if you have that, or if you can provide that, then it's up to you to, to let them know. But don't be so blunt about it. Like, you shouldn't just go in there and say, hey, you should download my app. But you might say, hey, I know the feeling or whatever. Or even just be kind of subtle, just establish contact with people and stuff like that. But, if you're always thinking that you're annoying people, then you're never actually going to go out there and do that. I mean, I get annoyed by the ads I see on TV, but it's a fact of life. I mean, that's the kind of thing. It's just something that we expect. And there's so many good books out there on social media. I mean, I've read so many of them myself. Gary Vaynerchuk has a lot of good books out. His last one, Jab, 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 Right Hook, is really, really good. But the best one I've read is The Art of Social Media by Guy Kawasaki and Peggy something. That one's probably the best one I've read so far. So that talks about more social media marketing. But it is a case of getting, people to download your app and not think that you're annoying them, but just letting them know what's going on. So that's what this week's about. Don't think that you're annoying people. So Now, if you haven't looked at the Overpass website in a while, we did something in this last week in terms of transparency. In order to be more transparent about things, like one of the things I hate about people who talk about apps is they talk about all this kind of stuff, like how great they are and this kind of stuff you should do, but you never see their download numbers. And then, you know, you might find out that actually they're doing much worse than you are. So I thought, you know, with Overpass, let's try to be a bit more transparent. So what we've done is we've linked up to the App Annie API, and every day it brings in new stats from our downloads. And then I just basically on every app on the site, like say if you go to the EarSpy page and scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see our daily download stats. So you can see which apps of mine are doing well and which ones are doing not so well. So that, you know, some of them only get, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, you know, downloads a day. But basically I'm separating by app store. So you'll see we get a lot from Google Play. We get about half as much from iTunes, and then we get hardly any from Amazon. So anyway, check it out. Check out the website. Subscribe to the newsletter, and you won't be disappointed. So that's it. I'll talk to you next week. Hey, I really hope you liked that video. Now I do these once a week, so if you want to hear more, or you want to hear more about our experiences with the App Store, either Google Play or iTunes, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel, and please like this video and leave a comment. I love reading the comments. I love hearing what you have to say, even if it's just hello or whatever. And like I say before, if you're not sure what to say in a comment, like I never know what to say in a comment, I'll make it easier for you. Like if you liked it, just go ahead and say gnarly, which is an 80s term. Or if you didn't like it, just say bogus. And if you didn't think any of it, just say eh, right? So that would be a big help. And another thing you could do, which I'd really appreciate it, if you're on the App Store and you want to try one of our apps, look up some of the Overpass apps, applications either on iTunes or Google Play, and leave a review and let us know what you think about it, either good or bad. But, we're all trying to, build up in the market. So that would be a big help. So that's it. I'll talk to you next week.